Chop chop early, what's good, Modern King Boxing? I'm here to talk about the exclusive Errol Spence interview that he did with his longtime girlfriend, Ayo, right after this intro. Let's get it. What's good? Top of the morning, Modern King Boxing back with another one. I finally got a chance to watch the Errol Spence and his longtime girlfriend, Ayo, interview. And it revealed a lot, you know, it revealed a lot about how the big channels were basically discrediting Crawford. All, you know, for the super chats, I'm going to say, and just the fan base in general that just follow Errol Spence. You know, and also discredit Crawford at the same time, but these guys wanted a super fight between two elite boxers. That don't make no sense. But, you know, he basically exposed a lot about, you know, the big channels and how they had all of these different dates for the fight, you know, and that was just not true. And he also revealed that that Floyd Mayweather basically has no say-so in his fight. And his girlfriend, Ayo, I must say, she asked some good questions. You know, she talked about him struggling, you know, with coming back after the Danny Garcia fight. Earl revealed stuff about that. He also revealed, you know, his hip. You know, he said he had, like, when he was fighting Danny Garcia, he felt like his hips were basically not doing the right thing. And, you know, and I understand, you know, we all pray for Earl Spence, you know, in his recovery, you know, because nobody wants to see no one die, especially when they had a promising career. I feel like Ayo, she kind of reminds me of like an authentic interviewer. You know, she actually broke out the lost tapes of Errol Spence because, you know, a lot of channels, they sit around and paint this picture that he was in training camps and doing all these different things, but he wasn't in training camps. He was basically dealing with his demons, you know, I feel, you know, and at this point, I think Crawford has the upper hand, you know, at basically beating him decisively. Flawless victory, you know, I must say. You know, and yeah, I'm a Crawford fan. I ain't gonna front. Terrence Crawford to the day, you know, he retires, you know, because he has done phenomenal things in boxing. And we can't forget that. We cannot forget that. You know, I call him the Hurricane Carter of the welterweight division. You know, Hurricane Carter got locked up, you know, in there out of something he didn't, you know, do, an atrocity. And they treat Terrence Crawford the same way in these boxing streets. You know, he's locked up out here is what I call it. But yeah, great interview by the lady. And, you know, like I said, Errol Spence said to Floyd Mayweather that Floyd Mayweather doesn't have no say-so in his fight getting made. And he says that him and Crawford are in deep negotiations, I would say. I'm going to say deep negotiations. He said they talked for 40 minutes. To me, that means that they're both willing to figure this out, you know, and shout out to all the historians, you know, who basically talk boxing every day and all of the actual real journalists, you know, who go out there like Sha News, The Source Experience, WCS, World Combat Sports, you know, and a slew of others. Zone 6 for being a true boxing fanatic. You know, just a lot of different things happening this week of boxing talk. around the YTPC. And yeah, this is my time. I just wanted to bring this to you and give you my insight on what I believe is promising for 2023, maybe at the end of the year. And that's just from a boxing fan's point of view. True Media Boxing Fan, Modern King Boxing. One, I'm a wolf.